the different keys that are available in the relational database. Now, in the general understanding you must have is the purpose behind having a database. Okay, a database main purpose is to store lots and lots of data. Okay, at the same time, it's not just a storage house where we keep storing the data, but it also is used for organizing the data, which is a very important point. Okay, organizing the data. Now, when I say organizing the data, it means that suppose I'm saving the records of 60 students in my class. Okay, I must be able to differentiate each record, because each record will correspond to a different student. Am I right? Each record will correspond to a different student. So I must be able to differentiate each record that has been saved in my table. Now, how do I differentiate? That's the next question. Now, first we understand why we have to differentiate. Now, we need to understand how do I differentiate. That's where keys come and play a role in differentiating the records. Now, we'll understand what exactly we're doing here. So, here it's given that the tuples within a relation must be unique. Okay, it means that no two tuples in a relation should have same value for all attributes. Now, instead of relation, you can replace this relation with a table. Okay, and instead of tuples, you can replace this tuple with record. So the basic understanding is that within a table, when I'm saving the data, okay, it's going to be saved in terms of records, in terms of rows. So each of those rows need to be unique. Okay, there should be at least one attribute. Okay, when I say attribute, the immediate thing that should come into your mind is column. Okay, there should be at least one attribute in which the data is unique and not null. Okay, and not null means it should not be empty. Okay, so there are certain constraints, there are certain restrictions that are put on these columns in order to make each record unique and different. For instance, let me give you an example. Okay, let's say when I am saving data of 60 students, I will use a roll number. Okay, a roll number will become an attribute. Okay, in the student table there will be an attribute, that is the column name, roll number. Okay, now each of those 60 records or rows that I'm going to save, each of them, okay, suppose I want to differentiate each of them, each row will have a unique value. That means if I put for a particular student roll number 5, same roll number 5 will not be repeated in any other record. Okay, that is the purpose of keeping the records unique. Now, we have certain keys in database. Okay, let us try to understand the three types that have been given in your textbook. Okay, so the first one is candidate key. Okay, now candidate key, remember the purpose of having a key is to be able to differentiate each record. Okay, so each record, now see this example here. In this, the record is 101 Ame Solapur CS. Okay, this is your first record. Okay, the second record has values 102 Shweta Ahmednagar ELE. Okay, this is your second record. Okay, so these are records, rows are records or tuples. Okay, and these roll number, name, city, branch code, MO number, that's a mobile number. Okay, each of these are attributes or columns. Okay, columns are another name for columns is attributes. Okay, so now each of these, let's say I'm going to use the candidate key, gives us the possibility of keeping all the records unique. Okay, I should be able to identify Amir's record, Shweta's record, Abdut's record. Okay, given in this example. So if I want to identify the records, one thing I can do is I can use name. Name could be a candidate key. Okay, suppose in my class of 60 students, there is going to be a unique name for each one of those students. I can use name as a key. Okay, I can use the name as a key to differentiate the records, or I can use the roll number. Correct? Or if there is a name and surname, it's not given in this example, but let's suppose there's a name and surname, I can even use the combination of that to differentiate the records. So these possible combinations, okay, are candidate keys, okay, and the key with which we differentiate each record and provide them with unique values is termed as primary key. Let's see the definition of the primary key. Out of one or more candidate keys, the attribute used to uniquely identify the tuples in a relation is called the primary key of that relation. Okay, so candidate keys are the various possibilities for primary key. Okay, various possibilities like roll number, it could be name, it could be a combo of name and surname. Those are candidate keys. Out of these candidate keys, if I as a programmer, I decide, okay, roll number is going to be the best option. It's never going to get mixed up. I'm not going to give anybody, any two students or three students the same roll number. It's going to be unique. Let's use that to differentiate all the records. Okay, set. So the primary key then becomes the roll number then becomes the primary key. Okay, so know this line is important. If you understand this line, then you can understand the concept of primary key. Okay, now we already gave this example. Like for instance, if we use two attributes like name and surname. Okay, name and surname, if I'm going to use and combined, I can make I can use the combination of these attributes, okay, as a primary key. Then this combination of two attributes is called a composite primary key. Okay, composite primary key. Okay, foreign key. Okay, now if you have, your first step is to understand what is a primary key, and the second step is to understand the foreign key. Okay, now let's see here. In this given example, okay, there is roll number, there is name, there is city, there is a branch code that's given here, okay, and there's a mobile number, okay. Now there is another table, okay, another table which contains the branch code and the branch name, okay. Now in this table, the branch code entry is going to be done just once. That's why it becomes the primary key. Okay, so IT, ELE, MEC. Okay, so all these are primary key. Now, when the primary key is being used in another table, okay, in relation with another table, okay, when it is forming that relationship, this usage of primary key in another table, this dependency is termed as foreign key. Okay, so a foreign key is an attribute whose value is derived from the primary key of another relation. Okay, let's take we're going to see these relationships so you will understand primary key and foreign key better. Let's do that next step. So always understand that in a database, when we are discussing about tables. Tables are not existing just by themselves. Okay, when we collect huge amounts of data, in organizing the data, we always have relationships, okay, which makes it easier for us to organize. We don't have to have everything in one table. Okay, at the same time, it makes our job of retrieving data, that is to get the data out, it makes it easier. Okay, let's understand the three relationships that are provided in your textbook. The first one is one-to-one. Okay, one-to-one relationship. Now see this example here. There's a student's table here. Okay, in the student's table, I'm going to give student ID. I'm going to give last name and first name. That's about it. Okay, that's about it. So in the student's table, these are the three attributes and these are values. Some values have been given. Okay, these values will go ahead in the record, in the row. Okay, now this student's table is in relationship with a contact info table. Okay, it is in a relationship with contact info table. This contact info table also has a student ID. It has got some address, city, phone number, okay, contact details of the student. Okay, now understand, in a one-to-one relationship, okay, the first table, the student's table, okay, is the first table, okay, that has a student ID, first name and last name. So the student ID is the primary key. Okay, here the student ID is the primary key. If I put in another student's record, I cannot use 1 2 3 4 5. I will use 6 7 8 9 0. Okay, I can use that. I cannot use the same numbers, or I can use 1 2 3 4 1. Okay, so this is a one-to-one relationship. Okay, so this is the primary key, and when it gets related to another table, okay, this student ID is dependent on the student ID of the first table. So this student ID in the contact info table is the foreign key. Okay, this is the primary key. When in relationship with another table, this is the foreign key. So what is the purpose of having this foreign key here is that unless a data, unless a record, okay, in the student table is entered, we cannot enter a record in the contact info table. For instance, suppose this 1 2 3 4 5 has not been entered in the student table, I cannot enter 1 2 3 4 5 in the contact info table. It's going to say, oh no, such a record does not exist, such an ID does not exist. Okay, similarly, another example could be, if I maintain a student's table here and I maintain a marks table here, I don't want to club both of them. Okay, same way I can create the dependency with roll number. Okay, try it out in your notebook. A very interesting concept. And once you try it out, you will also be clear with the concept. Okay, here another example is employee table. As an employee table, okay, there is a pay ID that is coming in the employee table. Okay, this pay ID, payment ID, is then linked, okay, to this pay ID of the pay table. Okay, this is another table. Now here you must understand that this is going to be the primary key. Okay, this is going to be the primary key, and when it is related to the employee table, okay, this is going to be the foreign key. So unless a pay ID has been entered here, we cannot enter a pay ID in the employee table. Okay, so basically this one-to-one relationship is, it means that two tables are related, okay, and the relationship is happening between the primary key and the foreign key. Okay, and one-to-one matlab dono table mein ek hi record rehna hai, us primary key ka aur us foreign key ka. Okay, so that's the dependency. Okay, the next one is one-to-many relationship. Okay, one-to-many or many-to-one. So if you see this example here, there is a customer, okay, customer table. There's a customer ID, customer name, city, mobile, etc. Okay, this is customer detail. Now, a customer will not buy just one thing, not necessary. The customer will have many orders, many things to buy. Okay, so each time a customer places an order for a certain product, what happens? An order in the order table, an order ID is generated. The order ID will be unique. Okay, the order ID will not get mixed up, it will be unique. But the order ID has to be then linked to the customer ID also. Correct? We need to know which this order belongs to which customer. Correct? So here the customer ID in the customer table is primary key, okay, and the customer ID in the order table is foreign key. So that is the one to many relationship, because when you have records in the order table, the customer ID can be repeated. Suppose I, as Deepa Fernandez, okay, my ID, my customer ID is going to be 101, let's say. Okay, I order for a laptop, I order for a mobile, and I order for a mic. Okay, there are three different orders I made. I'll have an order ID 123, but my customer ID will be 101 for the order number 1. For order number 2 also, my customer ID will be 101. And for my order number 3 also, customer ID will be 101. Correct? So that means I'll have three records with this customer ID. That's going to be many, right? More than one is many. Okay, but here when my information is going to be maintained in the customer table, 101 mera customer ID rahega, my name will be put here, city Ambernath, Thane, Bombay. Okay, so that should be the understanding. Here you can see this example also, same way it has been provided, same customer ID, but different orders have been given by the customer. So this is one to many. This is one to many relationship. Now, the next one is many to many. Many to many. Okay. So that means, see here, the example that has been given here is a certain book can be written by many authors, and many authors can write a certain book. A single author can write many books. Okay, so you should understand why many to many is coming in. A single book can be written by many authors, and a single author can write many books. Okay, so both combinations are possible. So suppose I'm keeping a book record here. Okay, a separate record ID has been created. Okay, and here the book ID is going to be a foreign key, which is dependent on the primary key of the book ID in the book detail. Okay, here the entry will be single. Okay, and here author ID has been given. Here also the entry will be single. But when I enter the records in the book table, okay, this book ID can be repeated more than one time, and this author ID can be repeated more than one time. The reason being, a single book can be written by a single author or many authors, and many authors can then also write a single book or many books. Okay, so with this is the last part of your database chapter. Okay, I hope you understand the concept, and my suggestion would be that you try these relationship out in your notebook, one to one, one to many, and many to many. Try these examples out, and it will help you understand the concept. Once you get the concept, you're good to go. Okay, so thank you very much.